Hi, this is Rob. On the TI-84 Plus CE graphing calculator, I'm going to show you how to graph a polynomial function, adjust the graphing window, zoom out on the graphing window, and zoom in on the graphing window using the zoom box on the TI-84 Plus CE graphing calculator. Press the Y equals key located on the very top left of the keypad. You will get this window. At the top, you will see plot 1, plot 2, plot 3. Make sure all three of these plots are disactivated. The plot 1 is activated because you can see a black box around it. To disactivate it, move the cursor up using the arrow key and highlight it. It is blinking. Then press the enter button on the lower right of the keypad. Now move the cursor down to Y1. The Y1, Y2, etc. are the number of different graphs you can display at the same time on the TI-84 Plus CE. The TI-84 Plus CE is a color graphing calculator. The blue box next to the Y1 means that the equation of that graph will display in blue. Let's graph the function x squared minus 2x minus 8. The x symbol is located right here, this key. Now there are two ways to do x squared. After you enter x, you can press this x squared key here. I'm going to clear this and show you the other way to enter x squared. To clear the equation, press the clear button here. Now enter a x. Now press this caret key. This is the exponent key. Now you see the cursor go to the exponent position. Now enter the exponent that you want. We want a 2. Now the cursor is still in the exponent position, we have to move it out of there by pressing the right arrow key here. Now we can enter the rest of the equation. But first, I'm going to clear this and show you how to enter a negative x squared. Press the clear key. If your equation is negative x squared minus 2x minus 8, we must use the negative key for the first coefficient. The negative key is here at the bottom right of the keypad, negative x squared. You must use the negative key and not the minus key if that first coefficient is negative. Now we'll clear this and enter our equation x squared minus 2x minus 8. Now to view the graph of this equation, press the graph key in the upper right of the keypad. The calculator draws the graph in blue. Now let's enter a second equation. Press the Y equals key. Press the down arrow to go to the Y2 equals. Let's enter x squared minus 2x minus 12. Press the graph key. Now you see how the graph of the equation that we just entered in red is a little off the screen? We need to see more of the y-axis. We can adjust the screen in one of two ways to get a better view of the graph. We can zoom out on the graph, or we can adjust the window of the graph area that we are viewing. First, let's adjust the graphing window. Press the window button here. These are the default settings for the graphing window. X-min is set to a negative 10 units. X max is set to a positive 10 units. X scale is set to 1. The Y min is set to negative 10 units. The Y max is set to positive 10 units. And the Y scale is set to 1. The problem we were having was with the Y axis. I'm going to make my Y min to negative 15. So go down to Y min and change that 0 to a 5. And press the graph button. There, now we can see both graphs better. I'm going to go back and reset the window settings back to the default settings, and thus put the y-axis back the way we had it. Press the zoom button located at the top of the keypad here. Go down to 6, Z standard. Press the enter key. Now the graph window is back to where it was. To confirm that, press the window key, and there, our settings are back to the default. Let's go back to the graph. Press the graph key. Now let's use the zoom button to zoom out on the graph. We do not want to zoom in. Zooming in will bring us closer. We want to zoom out. Press the zoom button located here at the top of the keypad. Go down to number 3, zoom out. Press enter. Now we have a blinking cursor. This is going to be the center of our zoom out. You can move the cursor any direction you want by pressing the arrow keys. You can click to move the cursor one spot at a time, or you can press and hold one of the arrow keys to make the cursor move faster. At the bottom of the graph, you can see the XY value as you move the cursor key. I'm going to move the cursor key back to the 0, 0 on the XY axis. Okay, now press the enter key to zoom out. It zoomed out a little too far, but we do not have any control of that. So we will use the zoom box, or Z box, to zoom into an area that is more interesting. To use the Z box, press the zoom key. The Z box is the first one, number 1. Press enter. Now we move the cursor using the arrow keys to an area where we want one of the corners of the zoom box to be. I'm going to move up and to the left. Press the enter key to make the corner of the box. Now move the cursor using the arrow keys to make the opposite corner of the box. I'm going to move the cursor down and to the right. The calculator automatically draws the box as you move the second corner of the box. There. That box area is the area we want to zoom in on. Press the enter key. The calculator redraws the graph to the boxed area. Okay, that's it. That is how to graph a polynomial function, how to adjust the graphing window, zoom out on the graphing window, and zoom in on the graphing window using the zoom box on the TI-84 Plus CE graphing calculator. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.